Good afternoon. Today, 15th of December. Formally, I will lecture again. So, please submit your those who have submitted the mini project. Those did not to submit, they please continue to participate in 20th December if possible. And those who have not submitted, please you submit it. That is taken as the assignment. That is number one. And January 2nd week, we will take for second mini project. The same group should continue. And if you have good project idea, most of you have a good project, so they should continue, or if they can otherwise. Yeah. So today, 15th of December, we are formally have a class of Google Colab. It doesn't mean that you have to continue the Google Colab. There are some positive points in it, and there's some negative points in it. So we must be very clear about it. The advantage of Google Colab is you get a 12 GB machine with GPU and TPU, and for only 12 hours, sorry, 12 GB and 12 hours, and that is good, and for any laptop you can work, and that is, I haven't done it, but that is the same facility available on Microsoft Azure also, but how much it is free, I don't know, I need to check it out. But should you also do for your own local laptop? I always suggest that your local laptop should have Python, bare Python on it, Ubuntu, sorry, bare Ubuntu on it, Ubuntu and Windows sometimes in sometimes it gives some little problems. So preferably Ubuntu should be there, and on Ubuntu you should practice the Python. You should download your Python and you should practice. And there are several IDEs probably you are using, but it is better to practice on sometimes better machine, because in your lab, if you have ever given a lab, then you will not get Google Colab and all this. And another thing, you require this bare machine, Ubuntu machine, Python. Whenever you are working on Raspberry Pi, probably you are aware of Raspberry Pi, one small computer system with 8 GB RAM. You can run on Ubuntu there, and everything is available as a whatever you have laptop, everything is available there. So it's a mean small credit card size of machine, and there you can do this. There's credit card size machine, and there you can attach your wireless keyboard and mouse, and your TV, HDMI TV can be the output, and it is a built-in Wi-Fi, so you can do anything, any web surfing, and there's a very good small a backup of your laptop. It's around 5,000 rupees, and there the Ubuntu is working on it. So that is also there. Also, you can work on Colab, but if you want to make a dedicated certain OpenCV image processing station, then you have to practice. So that is one thing. So today, that's another thing in Google, in Python environment, you should also know virtual environment, because on bare machine you meet different type of configurations of Python, maybe Matplotlib this version, or Python 3.6 version, or Python 3.7 version. Or sometimes good packages available, Python 2.0 version, though it is deprecated now. But if you need a different environment, then you can have to create virtual environment on your bare machine, Ubuntu or Windows. So that thing you have to practice on your bare machine. But for otherwise, for machine learning and deep learning, where I am doing work, there I found Google Colab is sufficiently good, very good. So basically, here is Google Colab. This is the internet, and one concept is Google Drive, that you all know, that everything you save it in Google Drive. Last day probably some pitch up there for half an hour, and Colab is there. Nothing is saved it here. You have to save for anything. If the session goes off, nothing will be there. So you have to save it on Google Colab, or you can download to your machine. Both the options are there. Let's check it up. This is Matplotlib. We have gone for demonstration. Let's go for coding. Is this screen is available? Is visible, please? Or should I make it a little larger? Is the screen is visible? Sir, yes.
It is visible.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. So this particular trick You can find it out. I have already this particular tick. This is the exclamation mark pip installed. This is IPython. This is in this Colab. This IPython is more interpretive. It is more fascinating. If you load extension auto time, that every cell how much seconds or milliseconds is required, it will give. So first I load this pip. It will load certain runtime. Once you have to load, and it has taken 2.5 seconds. From now onwards, any group of codes it's running, the time will be given. This is very helpful because you know whether your code is efficient or not. See, I am here. Say another thing. I'll make a calculation here. Say here another trick is import to S, this I am using is TPU or just GPU. Say I'll show you how to connect TPU. Just do this. It shows that the whole command connected to TPU, and you know you can change your runtime. Say I am doing a change my runtime here. I make it TPU. That is the reason TPU. If I say it's a none. Say here. I then again run this import twice. I think it is visible to you. Yeah, it is says is not connected to you, TPU. So these are the some small checks. And if I run again, say I have changed, you can change your runtime because this is freely available. So Colab says if you don't have any GPU job, don't give GPU. But I am trying it. Say GPU. I here make it. And run it. Yeah, not connected because it is connected to GPU, so not connected with TPU. So that's it. I wish to show that is one trick import. So what I'll tell again. There is another thing is you can upload any file to it. You just have to say Google Colab import files. These are all helpful. It is there. You just have to say Google Colab, and you have to say choose file from your desktop. I say this example one, a small data type 1 kilobyte file, and it would be loaded, and it will say how much file and length. So what is there? I have done. It is have to say. You have to say this from Google Colab import files command and upload it. Files upload, and this not only say that to get the characteristics, how much bytes and all these things. This is one small trick, and then you can this is another way in Drive, Google Drive. This is one of the best way you can upload file in Google Drive. Because you have to show the authentication, so I am going to my. I have to say this is my user ID. I have to say yes, allow, and that will give a code. I have to just copy it, and. Sorry, I'll just copy it. I have to paste it here. And it will be automatically my Google Drive is connected to this program. From this program, it is connected. Yes. Now, if you go do it again, you don't have to do again. It is automatically connected. Drive is already mounted. It's a good thing. It's one time. But for what reason it is given? It is for authentication, or Google want to make that nobody should go automatically. So probably that reason they have done this authentication. So go this. Yeah. Now I have done. This is another command import time. That example, perfect example, I'll give next time. So every this is a cell time I have given with time IT, but what is the total time of execution of the all the cells? But there, if the cells are there is a breaking, then you have to stop it. Then you have to, you cannot, no way, you have to add those cells. But if it is a long program, that is also another way, import time, you can actually the time ticks, you can time, and you can start time and end time, you can minus it. I will show this next day. But another important thing is import ways and import threading. That is a, basically there is a machine is running on there at your collab, and the ID of the main program is 56. So it is no use of it, but one thing, one interesting as a software engineer, you should know how is that machine working and what is the ID. Every time you go there, the ID would be different, and if you are anyway introduced to Java, then you know what is the main thread name, is the main thread, so it's a kind of a Java kind of Python or Java, that is the same, the main thread is working. That is very interesting to know. That is the reason I copied these things to you. Another thing is Matplotlib, that is, I have already given a example. This is, just a minute, whether I have given a recording mode, I probably use recording mode, just check. I hope it is recording. Yeah, record meeting is there. Yeah. So now this is a Matplotlib, one code is there. Here also Matplotlib, and another thing you see it here, I just make a little bit smaller, otherwise. Yeah, so I think it's visible, please, this code, anyone please?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. So there why I am doing this, can anybody can tell me why I am doing this? Because it's always, it is a, you make it a practice, whenever you load something, you always check, print out with this version name. So this is the one way, another is dot string, that way also can do. Here I have shown it that way, import numpy as np. Print np version dot format np, or another is np version plus, that is I am overloading the plus and string string to np dot version, both. If you just run it, you see the that is the MPL, Matplotlib version, np version, and the another np version, that is a two way. So this is the recommended way. I suggest this is the most of the professional software does this way. So this way. So anything, any library you are loading it, so you just print it so that it will be debug, will be easier. That is one way. And that is a Matplotlib, a simple Matplotlib. Okay. So today I have not done much because it's the fag end of the day, how you have given a lab. That what I have, just repeat once more again, that he is the man, the doctor, he has developed this, he is the doctor, he developed the whole single-handed Matplotlib. Unfortunately, he is some cancer, he died, John Hunter 2012. So Matplotlib is one of the core package of with all the graphics, and it can run on any machine, Unix, desktop, your mobile, that's great. And that is today I am emphasized on Google Colab mode because I am practicing Google Colab. But when you not to use Colab, because whenever you want a dedicated, your program should run, right, Raspberry Pi or an exam, online, not online maybe, and your college, then you may not be permitted to run your code Google Colab. You have to practice the your Python should run on your Python virtual environment. I would suggest that you should load Linux machine. And I also suggest that there are several versions of your same program may run. Some may take Matplotlib div version, some may div version, or np pandas div version, or Python 3.6. There is a Python 3.6, another utilities are running. Python 2 is another versions are there. If you want to test all this program, it is better to use virtual environment. How to create virtual environment is only 5 or 6 lines. You can see it in your this thing. I also try to show you one day. So that is the reason why you not to use Colab. Otherwise, Colab is good. because you get not only 12 GB CPU and also GPU and TPU, and GPU and TPU, how to connect and reconnect, how to test it, I have already shown some code, and all the plethora of ports are available on the internet. That's it, and another is today I am finishing. Now I am open to